वेलकम माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स इन द क्लास 12th ऑफ इंग्लिश. आई एम रश्मि, लेक्चरर, AD गवर्नमेंट गर्ल्स इंटर कॉलेज, गोरखपुर. एंड टुडे आई एम हेयर टू प्रेजेंट बिफोर यू द लेसन 3rd ऑफ आर शॉर्ट स्टोरी. द नेम ऑफ द शॉर्ट स्टोरी इज द लॉस्ट चाइल्ड बाय मुल्क राज आनंद. डियर चिल्ड्रन, द टाइटल ऑफ द स्टोरी is itself suggestive of so many things. But before we go for that, I have a question for you. That when we go with a child to a fair, what is the biggest fear that we have in our mind for that particular child? Naturally, your answer will be that the child, there is the possibility of his missing in the fair. Yes, children, and it happens in this story too. Now we have to look at that what is the mental status, mental development that Mulk Raj Anand projects here. We find the contrast in the behavior of the child and before and after getting lost. Now, before we go for the entire story, let's have the objectives of the story. First, to know the theme of the story. What is the theme of the story? What does Mulk Raj Anand want to say? We will trace here. To be aware of the child psychology. Yes, children, this story beautifully presents the psychology of the little child. Third, to know the meaning of difficult words. As we read the entire paragraph, we find certain difficult words. It will be clear to you. Fourth, to be well familiar with the Indian society and situation. As we read the story, we get well aware of the entire story and we find the traces, we find certain things about Indian society and situation. He has presented it so realistically that you are in impression of that the Mulk Raj Anand has a very clear idea about the Indian society. Fifth, to feel the parental love and affection. Yes, Mulk Raj Anand beautifully shows it that parental love is quite important in a child's life. So, these were the objectives that we have to obtain during our study. But before we go for the story, let's have a look on the author, Mulk Raj Anand, a prominent Indian author of novels, short stories and critical essays in English. Second, he is known for his realistic, sympathetic portrayal of the poor in India. Dear children, he focuses on the poor of India and he has a sympathetic corner in his heart for those persons. Third, birth 12 December 1905, Peshawar, death 28 September 2004, Pune, education, graduation with honors in 1925-24 from Punjab University in London, additional studies at the University of Cambridge and London. He just pursued his further studies in the Cambridge and London. Now, come to the awards. Sahitya Akademi Award, Padma Bhushan. Major literary works, he wrote several novels, The Untouchable, The Coolie, Two Leaves and A Bird, The Village, Across the Black Waters, The Sword and the Sickle. Now, he was the founder of the magazine Mark. So these were the important points about Mulk Raj Anand. Now we will move towards the characters of the lost child. Dear children, when we read any story, it is quite essential to have the knowledge of the characters of the story. So in this way, we are well aware of the qualities of those particular characters, and when these are the things, if we have in our mind, we can study the entire story in a proper arranged manner. First, the lost child. The lost child is very, if we talk about the characters, the first character which comes, it is naturally the child. So here the child is very excited as he goes to a fair with his parents, but at the end he gets lost, as it is the title of the story, in the fair. He is so innocent that he leaves all the demands and wants his parents only. It happens with you too. So when we think about a child and he goes to a fair, naturally there are so many attractions and the child gets fascinated towards those attractions. It's a natural phenomena, dear children. It happens with everyone. But Mulk Raj Anand has shown that the child had the feeling earlier, but what happens when he gets lost in the fair, he has the only demand of his parents. Second, the unknown man. Who is this unknown man? The unknown man is very kind and generous man. He tries each and everything to console the lost and sobbing child. When the child gets lost in the fair, he starts crying, and then a man comes. He shows sympathy, but it goes all in vain. So it was the unknown man. Now his parents, the child goes with his parents to the fair, and he is well aware of his parents' psychology. I hope that you must have felt this psychology, you must have this idea that when you go with your parents and sometime what happens that you demand for so many things, and it's not necessary that all those demands would be fulfilled. Now, these were the information about the characters. Let's move to the theme of the story. We come to know about the characters, the themes. In this way, what happens that we get a very good idea of the story, and in this way we get the better understanding of the story too. Now, theme of the story. The story is based on the theme of close bond that children share with their parents. Dear children, you must also have felt this kind of bond for your parents. The lost child forgets about his desires and yearns deeply for his parents. He wants only his parents. When he gets lost, everything loses its significance. Earlier, what happened? When he saw the so many things, he got attracted towards that. But the moment he gets lost in the fair, he wants only his parents. The most valuable demand for him is parents. Everything loses its significance, and the only thing that matters in his wish to be reunited with his parents. Now we start to know about the story. First of all, we will look at the introduction. It is the festival of spring. As you can see in this picture, that you get the idea of the fair. You must have gone in a fair, so you have the better understanding. It is the festival of spring. Many people are going to see the fair. There is a little boy who walks along with his parents. He is usually left behind because he has many attractions towards the beautiful and attractive things on the way. Dear children, when you read this particular story, you feel that you have a kind of affection for the story because you also go through the same experiences in your life, even today. And if we talk about your childhood, you must have felt this kind of feeling. So whenever any student goes to read this chapter, he gets attracted towards this story because it is his own experience. Now, things of child attraction. The stalls of toys and sweets on the way attract the child very much. Though his father got angry, but his mother pacified him and diverted his attention towards other thing. You have also experienced it that when you go in a fair, what happens? You demand for something and the next moment your father, maybe your father, rejects it. So think about the mentality. On the other hand, we have a mother, and what does she do? That she tries to console, she tries to pacify the entire matter because she has a soft corner and she tries to make the entire atmosphere cool. And how does she do? She diverts the attention. And he sees that a sweetmeat seller selling burfi. He says, "I want burfi." But he does not wait for his parents' reply as he is aware of their negative answer. Dear children, when we look at this story, we find that we have experienced the same thing with ourselves. इस story में जैसा कि बताया गया कि एक छोटे से बच्चे की कहानी है जो कि एक मेले में जाता है और मेले में बहुत सारी चीज़ों को देख करके things of child attraction, बहुत सारी चीज़ें उसके सामने आती हैं, खिलौने आते हैं स्टॉल्स पे देख के, मिठाइयों की दुकान आती है, झूले आते हैं और सपेरे आते हैं, बैलून्स की दुकान दिखाई देती है, तो इन गुब्बारों को देखता है, तो इन सारी चीज़ों को देखने में वह क्या होता है, वह मंत्रमुग्ध हो जाता है, उनके प्रति आकर्षित होता है और वो चाहता है कि ये सारी चीज़ें उसके पास हों। लेकिन इन सब में जो सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्ट है वो ये कि ही डज नॉट वेट फॉर हिज पेरेंट्स रिप्लाई। रास्ते में गुजरते हुए बहुत सारी चीज़ों को वो देखता है, फिर एक मिठाई की दुकान पे बर्फ़ी उसको बहुत अट्रैक्ट करती है, बहुत आकर्षित करती है और वो कहता है कि मुझे बर्फ़ी चाहिए, लेकिन ही डज नॉट वेट फॉर द आंसर। वो अपने माता पिता के उत्तर की अपेक्षा, उसके लिए इंतज़ार नहीं करता क्योंकि उसे पता होता है कि वहाँ से नकारात्मक उत्तर मिलेगा। यहाँ पर हम एक बच्चे के मनोवृत्ति को, उसके मनोविज्ञान को बहुत अच्छी तरह से समझ सकते हैं क्योंकि हम स्वयं उस उम्र से गुजरे हैं। ऐसी स्थिति में आप सब ने भी यह फील किया होगा अपने जीवन में कि जब कभी ऐसी स्थिति आती है, आप बहुत सारी चीज़ों को देखे होंगे और ऐसी स्थिति में यह कभी संभव नहीं होता कि आप सारी चीज़ों को ले लें और आपको पता होता है कि वो सारी चीज़ें आपको उपलब्ध नहीं कराई जाएंगी आपके माता पिता के द्वारा। सो दिस वॉज द थिंग्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन। नाउ वी विल मूव। देन ही विटनेसेस गार्लैंड्स balloons, snake charmer, but it proves all in vain. For him, lastly, the child sees a roundabout. He wants to enjoy a ride on it. This time, he could not check himself and ultimately says, "I want to go in the roundabout. Please, father, mother." The child goes through so many stalls and he gets attracted towards that. But he does not wait for the answer from his parents' side. But when he looks at the roundabout, he finds himself that now he would not be able to suppress his desire. At that time, he ultimately tells that, "I want to go in the roundabout, please father, mother." What happens next, we will see here. The child gets lost when the boy asks to swing and does not get answer. He turns back and looks at his parents. He finds them missing. He cries aloud, "Father, mother." So it is the point when he gets lost in the fair, and it was the fair that I started in the beginning of our study, that I asked you a question that what do the biggest fear we have when we go with a little child to a fair. So it happened with him. इस स्टोरी में वह बच्चा बहुत सारी चीज़ों को देखता है मेले में, गजरे को देखता है, गुब्बारों को देखता है, सपेरों को देखता है, और बहुत सारी चीज़ों को देखते हुए बस वो चला जाता है। अपने माता पिता से वो किसी प्रत्युत्तर की अपेक्षा नहीं करता है, लेकिन जब अंत में उसे एक बड़ा सा झूला दिखाई देता है और वह उस समय ये महसूस करता है कि अब वो अपनी इच्छाओं को दबा नहीं सकता और वो बोलता है, लेकिन बोलने के बाद ही क्या होता है कि इस बार वह अपने माता पिता से उत्तर की अपेक्षा करता है, और इसी अपेक्षा में जब वह पीछे घूमता है तो देखता है कि उसके माता पिता उसके साथ नहीं हैं, और वह चिल्लाता है कि उसके माता पिता कहाँ गए। नाउ हियर कम्स दैट अननोन मैन which we discussed in the characters. A man lifts the child in his arms. A man lifts the child in his arms. He takes pity on him. He takes him to the flower seller, juggler, sweetmeat, to the roundabout, but the boy does not want anything except his parents. Now, this is quite interesting that earlier the boy, the little child, he demanded for many things. He had a desire in his heart. A man lifts the child in his arms. When a man looks at him crying, he finds that this boy is alone. He takes pity on him. He gets sympathetic towards that boy, and he takes him to the flower seller. Now he goes through so many things which he had a demand in his heart and he did not present it before his parents. But now the situation has quite changed and he does not want a single thing among these things. He does not want flowers, seller, garland, juggler, sweetmeat, etc. And the only thing he wants is his parents. He says that now he has the only desire to have his parents. Now, come to the conclusion. The author has described the condition of a lost child whose hopes are shattered. He says only one thing at last, "I want my mother, I want my father." In the entire story, ultimately what happens, that द चाइल्ड इज टू मच सैड एंड ही हैज ओनली वन डिमांड दैट इज ऑफ हिज पेरेंट्स। इस स्टोरी में जो बच्चा है वो कई सारी चीज़ों को देखता है और उसके मन में एक इच्छा होती है कि वो इन सारी चीज़ों को खरीद सकता, लेकिन उस क्षण जब वो अपने माता पिता को खो देता है और वो सारी चीज़ें उसे उपलब्ध कराई जाती हैं तो भी उस बच्चे के लिए उन चीज़ों की कोई वैल्यू, कोई मूल्य नहीं रह जाता है। अगर कोई चीज़ उसके लिए बहुमूल्य है तो वो सिर्फ उसके माता पिता। नाउ वी हैव सर्टेन डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स एंड मीनिंग हेयर, इट विल बी क्लियर टू यू। गेली क्लैड, ड्रेस्ड इन अ कलरफुल क्लोथ्स, रंगीन वस्त्रों को धारण किए हुए। स्वाम, क्राउड, भीड़। मैरिज, इल्यूजन, भ्रम। कैंसी, वेरी थिन, बहुत पतला। फैसिनेटेड, ग्रेटली अट्रैक्टेड, बहुत ज़्यादा किसी चीज़ के लिए आकर्षित हो जाना। रिटरेटेड, रिपीटेड। डिसकॉन्सोलेट, डिप्रेसिंग, डिप्रेसिंग मीन्स निराश करने वाला। रिपीटेड मीन्स दोहराना। वेरी, टायर्डनेस, थकान। क्लस्टर, ग्रुप, समूह। थ्रॉन्ग्स, क्राउड, इसका मतलब भी भीड़ होता है। इम्प्लेकेबल, एक्सेसिवली ओवरपावरिंग, बहुत ज़्यादा अपना अधिकार जताना। तो ये सारी डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स एंड मीनिंग। क्वेश्चंस फॉर इवैल्यूएशन। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, हाउ वर द पीपल गोइंग टू द फेयर। द पीपल वर गोइंग टू द फेयर ऑन फुट, ब्लॉक कार्ट्स एंड हॉर्सेस। Why did the child want to suppress his desire? This question is quite important, dear children, that he wants to suppress his desire. The reason behind it is that he knows the eternal denial from his parents, that his parents they would not allow him to buy everything that he demanded for. What was the first demand of the child while accompanying his parents? The first demand was of barfi. He says that I want barfi. Describe the plight of the child when he had lost his parents. The child gets too much sad. He starts crying and says only one thing, that he wants nothing. The only thing that he wants is his parents. So in this way we have got the idea of the story. Now it's time for homework. What were the things the child was attracted to the fair before getting lost? I hope that you must be able to answer this question, as we have discussed it so many times in this study session. What according to you is the sweetest position of a child? Dear children, think about it, then answer it. Now we have the message of the story. Dear children, when we read any story, it's very important to know that what do we get out of that, what do we learn out of that. And so far as we analyze this entire story, we find certain things. For example, it describes the episode in the life of a child who gets lost in a fair. You are aware of that. Through this story, we get the better understanding of the psychology of little children, their simplicity and innocence. Dear children, this story is quite important for so many points of views. For example, that it traces the psychology of a child. When we think about a child, a child is quite innocent, quite simple, and when he goes to a fair, he has an immense desire for having everything that he looks at. So why does it happen? The reason behind it is that he has the desire, he does not think any other perspective, and he wants everything from the fair. But suddenly this desire, this demand changes when a child finds that he is quite alone in the entire fair. And he thinks that nothing is important, the parental love and affection, that is important for him to survive. So it happens with everyone. When we are surrounded, when we have parents, we don't understand the value of parents. And when a time comes that we miss them, at that time we understand the worth of the parents. So this story focuses on the importance of the parents too. And we should have the understanding of the child psychology, because children are quite simple and innocent. Dear children, I hope you must have enjoyed the entire story and you must have learned the theme of the poem. You must have analyzed the entire story, and it is related, it is very much close to your life. So you should read it again and again. I hope you will get many more things you will get if you read again and again. So that's all for today. Thank you very much.